My name is Seth Garza. My book title is Scarum Fair. My poem title is Cat Hair Stew. My author is Jessica Swain. I believe the author organized the text with a sequential order for this poem so she can describe how gruesomely it's made. The poem states that she serves it in a fur-lined cup and waits for you to cough it up, probably to indicate that she gets money without ever making more. My visualization indicates that she adds moldy mice and rotting fish to show the reader how disgusting it is.
My name is Ayan. The book title of my book is Antarctic Antics. My poem title is Antarctic Anthem. The author of this book is Judy Sierra. In my mind, I can picture that the penguins were singing when I read Anthem. I can infer the author used Parktika to show it's a big place. It keeps saying Tika to show what it has.
The rabbit is hearing music coming from the animals around them. The music is way beyond their inner ear, but very soft, softer than the ocean swell. Tinier than cutting wings and cat's paws and little things like that.
My name is Aubrey. My book title is Poetry for Young People. My author is Frances Goldmarker Bolin. In my mind, I can picture a bee being surprised by the note that the fly made. The purpose of this poem is that sometimes you should be at work or reply to your boss and not ignore your boss. I can infer that the author used punctuation because if there wasn't, I would have talked like a robot.
Hello, my name is Vishen, and my book title is Something Big Has Been Here, and my poem title is My Neighbor's Dog is Purple. The author is Jack Przlucki, and I can infer the author used a descriptive segment to describe the dog is not a dog. The poem stated, "My neighbor's dog is quiet, so I think it does not bark." Text stated, "Its eyes are large and green, which is why I think it is not a dog."